still here at EGX, and now we've been following for quite a while. Last year at EGX, we showed No Truce and Furies. We're back with it, although it has a new name.
Disco Elysium.
Can you explain, well, for those that haven't seen the No Truce and Furies, can you explain what the game is and what it is?
It's a detective RPG. Firstly, it's a detective. You go around in a reasonably sized open world, and then you have like, I think we have about 90 voice characters you can talk to, beginnings of the dialogue of voice. So you interrogate them, you ask questions from them, and then you use the information you get from one guy against the other guy to find out more about this murderer investigator. So on the other hand, it's an RPG, so while you're doing this, you can put points into becoming like a good cop who kind of like convinces people, or like a philosophical cop, like a kind of true detective guy with sort of big worldview kind of stuff. Or you could be just become like a monster who just beats people in the face and forces them to give you information. So you're building this kind of character, you're kind of vision of the detective you'd like to be, or like you'd like to see in the story. So you can be a Sherlock Holmes guy, but you can be a Lynchian kind of Dave Cooper, Twin Peaks guy who has like weird visions and speaks about feminism to people. Or like you can have like a communist cop who goes around and tries to rouse the people and solve the case. So there's a lot of like roping mechanics in it too, but it's also a pretty hardcore police procedural and detective game.
And the world is set, it's quite bleak and wild.
Yeah, but it's at the same time it's very colorful, like the art direction is like, there's just quite cool, all kind of romantic colors in it. So I would say the character itself is very bleak and wild, like that you possibly will live having in this game, and then driving your kind of direction. But the world itself is actually quite pretty. It's kind of seaside city of Revachol, where you get to like explore it and then find secret areas and so on. But yeah, being a cop is the ugly part. Yeah. It's a hard job. No. So yeah, you get to see all kinds of unsavory characters in this game. So I expect it to be a massive shit show when we release it. People are gonna be pretty angry at us probably for language use and some kind of stuff. So
language.
Yeah, of course not.
It's very, you get a idea of the people that are around and how they talk.
But as it is a kind of, detective games I've tried before, and they're pretty nice ones, like L.A. Noir and so on. But what the RPG thing brings to it is a kind of freedom to go about the case in any way you want. It's been very hard to establish the game. For us, it means you can open every door, or knock down doors, which is what comes to it. Comes to a door opening machine. You have like a physical instrument skill for it, like for kicking that stuff down. And then when you go around this kind of place, you can start your own case, like start exploring your place, and then think like, yeah, this is going to be a case now. Like there's a doom commercial area where all businesses are failing. Why? Is there maybe something supernatural here? As you start these investigations, some of them may put your main investigation into new light. You may find out new things about it. Maybe they're starting to converge these cases.
Yeah, so that would be information that you haven't seen before.
But other players who don't start this kind of side case, and I'm not saying the Doom commercial area will do that, will not get this information, will not get, probably may even not solve the case in the right way because of it. So there's a lot of sequencing and freedom to go about and to explore this thing that hasn't quite been tried with the detective thing, and I think it makes it really feel like a detective game.
Is it possible to fail in this game?
Yeah. Yeah,
you spend your time and then the guy gets away or
many ways. It's pretty easy to fail as a cop, like doing this thing. So it's possible to get shot and die. There's also, I'd like to say, this kind of set piece, hand animated kind of combat scenes where people will shoot at you, and you will die if you don't do it right, or you will get injured and limp around and people will comment on it. So there's a kind of physical survival element, because police work isn't all, or talking about this. Yeah. So that's one part. But then there's also the mental part. We just didn't put the tools together. So there's a, I hope, quite a lot of challenge in there, you know, how to build your character really into a strong detective, you know, against all odds, to really zoom in and solve this case. So,
we mentioned earlier, now called this for this year, before last year called No Truce this year. What brought that game change about?
Well, when we started, development of this game, it was 3 years ago. We have a small team of 25 people, and I was expecting it to be a smaller game. I was expecting to be a bit of a novella, you know, like a shorter story, like a crime story. And No Truce for Furies, I think, is a great name for a shorter story. But as we made this game, it spiraled out of control into a kind of 40, 50 hour, like it's a
big thing.
Yeah, it's really, it's gotten big, but it's, I would say it's reasonably sized, but it's quite big. We needed a name that would more sound like a flagship, kind of be like a novel. So this Elysium for me is a name of a novel. And it also goes with the world works. So it's not set in Valley, this game. It's not set in LA or somewhere. It's set in a completely other world, where there are, you know, guns and swords and motor cars and telephones and kind of modern place. And then we call this setting Elysium. So it's also a way for us to introduce this world for a long time.
This is
the harbinger. This is the kind of, I really think it's a great introduction to a great world that we've done. But it's not a world you've seen before. It's not a high fantasy or a cyberpunk setting or nothing. It's a complete alternate reality kind of, with its own nation states and nothing. But it's not ultimate history, it doesn't have anything to do with it. So this is a kind of like first introduction. You're just being thrown into it. And then you're gonna have to slowly start realizing that, hey man, this isn't our world, is it? And of course we think people are gonna like it, and I get to explore other facets of it.
I've actually been following you guys since September. Any plans for a release date now?
This Elysium will be released the second half of 2018, so this year. Second half of this year. We are putting out an announcement trailer at E3 this year, and then we're announcing the game later. And that will have a release date. So,
not long to wait for that.
Yeah. And no backing down for us, so we've got to get that guy out.
And what, if you mentioned it's for PC, is it going to be for any other platform or PC only?
It's going to be PC only first, and then, you know, if the trade winds are willing, we'll definitely bring it to PlayStation and Switch and console platforms, because since this game doesn't have like traditional turn-based combat, the combat happens in these violent bursts of like aggression that may happen in the middle of an interrogation somewhere, or you may be, not going to spoil stuff, or you may be waylaid on your way somewhere. So it isn't that dependent on a mouse control. So I think it would translate well to a joystick. But PC is like our home.
Yeah, your home. Yeah. I was saying this is big and complex and deep. So what, if you've got one tip to do something on the internet, what would it be?
Don't be afraid to make an idiot out of yourself and fail and stuff. Like really just, there will be challenges later on, but failing skill checks is pretty fun in this game. Like you can say really stupid things, and that may sometimes bring you really interesting results. Yeah. So don't be afraid to be the worst cop you can be. But if you want to be a nice boring cop, you can try and go that way too. But there's hell to be raised here. Like the bad cop playthrough is very exciting too. We hope people are going to do 2 or 3 playthroughs of it. There's a lot of And that would be like my second thing, which would be to really understand how insane we have gotten with choice and consequence in this game. How you can go down like this minute rabbit holes and just everything spirals out of control. Out of
taking this quite a bit.
Everything spirals out of control. You have to play it like three times to really appreciate how wide it is.
I can't wait.